The treatment for transplant-eligible newly diagnosed myeloma patient is clearly evolving because although the standard of care continues to be induction followed by high-dose therapy, autologous stem cell transplantation, and maintenance therapy, I think that important changes occurred within this conventional platform. First, because the main objectives have changed, and now we know that the depth of the response matters in newly diagnosed myeloma patients, and minimal residual disease assessment and minimal residual disease negativity is the new complete response, and this would be the main objective for every newly diagnosed myeloma patient transplant eligible. The second important change is the induction regimes, because we are moving from 2 to 3 drug-based combination and from 3 drug-based combination to 3 drug-based combination plus the monoclonal antibodies. Today, targeting CD38, but in the future, we will have monoclonal antibodies targeting different antigens expressed on the surface of the plasma cells. But another important question around the transplant eligibility is if every newly diagnosed myeloma patient transplant eligible has to receive autologous stem cell transplantation, or in other words, if we can potentially skip transplanting some patients. Today, we don't have a consolidated data in order to answer to this question, but I think that there are different factors that can be considered in order to make the right choice. The risk status, and we have to consider not only the ISS staging, but also the cytogenetic abnormalities, together with the minimal residual disease assessment. And the data we are coming from phase 2 randomized studies in which it's true that the question has not been specifically what is the role of transplant indicates that maybe in the future patients at ISS 1 with no high-risk cytogenetic abnormalities, if after optimal induction regimes they achieve minimal residual disease negative and this minimal residual disease negative is sustained over time, could potentially skip autologous stem cell transplantation because the outcome could be comparable to those patients receiving autologous stem cell transplantation. And the main advantage for patients is that they will be free of exposition to high-dose melphalan, followed by autologous stem cell transplantation, admission into the hospital for approximately 1 month, and some side effects that can occur after autologous stem cell transplantation. However, I would like to remark that we don't have yet consolidated data to support this. This is something that it is being investigated in clinical trials, and definitely we need the data coming from phase 3 randomized trials in order to consolidate the role of autologous stem cell transplantation. And today, in 2020, I have to summarize that high-dose therapy followed by autologous stem cell transplantation continues being the standard of care for newly diagnosed myeloma patients if we consider that the patient is transplant eligible based not only on the chronological age, but the biological age, comorbidities, disabilities, and why not patients' preferences.